first heard this story, aged 10 or 11, in a classroom with high windows, sitting at an old-fashioned sloping desk with a groove along the top of the slope for pens and pencils to rest in, initials and odd glyphs gouged deep in the wood grain. Our teacher, Mr. Faulkner, was a tall man with scant hair, flat red cheeks, and teeth pitched at eccentric angles. He wore silk paisley neckerchiefs and cardigans darned with wrong-coloured wools, and he kept his sunglasses on indoors for genuine optometric reasons. He was approaching retirement and liked to finish term with a story. One of the stories he read us was Paul Gallico's The Snow Goose.
Breathing to a rhythm.
was over a different land and surrounded by strange birds that she had never seen before. I remembered Mr. Faulkner reading to us in the high-windowed classroom, women gathering at practice tees to loosen up their swings. I closed the book. There was a pale grey light inside the tent. Paula and Natsik were asleep beside me, but I couldn't sleep. Even now, I could hear geese.